Now if I right-click on this dimension line, on our shortcut menu, we see something called Dimensions. And it brings up a dialog box about our dimension line. The first thing that I want to look at is this guide distance at 0.04. What this is the distance between our fill handle and our guideline. To make this a little clearer, I'm going to change this to 0.25. Now we see we can lock in our dimension line to the side of the object we're trying to measure, and we can still set the distance between the object and our guideline. Let's right-click again, bring that back. I'm going to set that back to 0.04. And now we're going to change the guide overhang. What the guide overhang is the other side of this arrow. Let's change that one to 0.25. And we'll see this side grow as well as the bottom. So the bottom was restored and the top we stretched out to 0.25. We're going to leave this at 0.25, and now we have our line distance. It's set at 0.31. I'm going to bring this down to 0.20. What should happen is this line should come down, but this line will stay the same distance away from the arrow, but the entire line will shrink. So our line shrunk, this line stays the same, but the distance between our arrow and our shape got smaller. The next thing on here are the left guide and the right guide. To show that, I'm going to cancel out, and we're going to take away these dimension lines. I'm going to add another object. And we want to measure all the way to the end of our new object at the bottom. But with this dimension line way up here, we want to bring this down so it's a little closer. So I'm going to right-click on the dimension line and change our right guideline to 1 inch. We can see in our preview that it grew to 1 inch. And now we see in our dimension line itself that it extended it 1 inch. It didn't make it 1 inch total. It extended it from where it was 1 inch. Now, with this selected, if I put my arrow over this bottom point and click and hold it, we see a hand. If I bring the hand up, it doesn't look like anything's happening. But when I release my mouse button, the line comes up. So I can bring that up or down just using my mouse. This other handle here, if I click that, I can rotate it. And the top handle, clicking on that, we see the four-sided arrow, which we know will move around our entire object. Going to bring the handle back up and bring it back down to 1 inch. Let's get rid of our extra rectangle and go back into our dialog box here. Measure below the object. Clicking on that shows us below and above. We saw the results of this at the beginning when we did our right to left was above, left to right to make the object below. Decimal places too, that one's pretty obvious. Text position, this is really our measurement position. We've got it locked in at auto vertical, auto horizontal. I'm taking these off. And we can go above the line, in the middle of the line, as we see right here, and below the line. Or we can put it at one of the ends the same way, above or below. I'm going to put it right in the middle. Parallel to line. What this is the angle of our number. If I uncheck this and click OK, we see that it turns perpendicular, which would be probably a little more appropriate for our vertical line than our horizontal. So I'm going to recheck that. We've got show unit of measure, and then if we click this drop down, we can change the unit of measure. So I'm going to change this to centimeters, and I'm going to show the unit of measure. So it's saying 2.54 centimeters. Going back in here, if I uncheck the show unit of measure, it's just going to say 2.54, and we're going to have to know that that is centimeters. Now, looking at the top of this, we have something called automatic. Automatic will grab that unit of measure that we saw when I went into tools options at the beginning, and we saw that it was set to inches. So that's why automatic will bring up inches. And I'm going to leave this one centimeter, just so it'll be different. Now, you might be saying, if this only works for the one line, I want to change it for all my dimension lines. What we want to do is change our line style. To do that, I'm going to click on the styles and formatting. And we see we have one for dimension line. Right clicking on that, I can modify. And I can change this to automatic or leave it at inch. I'm going to put it at automatic. And I'm going to add another dimension line at the bottom, going right to left because it's on the bottom. So now we have our dimension line set at 1 inch, except for this one on the top, which we changed into centimeters.